Good Tuesday morning. We're still in Luke chapter 11, and this is a passage that's an abbreviated passage compared to the one in Matthew, where Jesus is talking about the light of our lives and how that light needs to shine. Let me read in verse 33. No one, after lighting a lamp, he says, puts it away in a cellar, nor under a peck measure, but on the lampstand, in order that those who enter, that is the house, may see the light. And he says, the lamp of your body is your eye. And when your eye is clear, your whole body is also full of light. When it's bad, your body's full of darkness. Then watch out that the light in you may not be darkness. If therefore your whole body, he says, is light with no dark part in it, it will be wholly illuminated as when the lamp illuminates you with its rays. So in this case, he's talking about what comes into our life and our eyes and then goes out. The one thing about light is that it's meant to illumine. The thing about light, it's meant to reflect the nature of its source. So with a lamp, whether it's fire or incandescent or whatever, or LED, that is made to illuminate its source. And so when the electricity passes through the filaments or whatever, and then it lights up in a bright way. And the same way in our own lives. What Jesus is saying here is what you let into your life then comes back out of your life, and it illuminates your source. One of the things we are in this world is light and salt. We are to be here, and we are here, in order to reflect what has come into our lives, the nature of illumination, the nature of transformation, the nature of Christ's presence, and the gift of the Holy Spirit is to be what comes out of our lives, and the fruit of the Holy Spirit, the transformation that we're experiencing by God's own mercy and grace. The transformation that God's bringing about in our lives is to be reflected. The source is God's presence in our lives. The source is our salvation by grace. The source are all of these things, and we're to reflect that out into the world. And when it's done properly, it has amazing effects. Not only does it show people the light of Christ, not our light, but the light of Christ, but it begins to draw people to that light. As if you were in a darkened area and you saw a far off light, you're drawn to that because you want to see. People in this world are hurting, and the way that they find Christ is through the light, not just the witness that we have, the light that shines, that draws them to that light, that they may find their way in this life. Some are hurting, some are confused, some are full of doubt, but our light that has come to us from Jesus Christ lights the pathway for them to come to Him. Let your light shine today. Don't hide it. Let it be brighter and brighter and brighter. Let it be fully exposed to a darkened generation. Heavenly Father, may our light shine in ways that we've never dreamt before and draw people to You because of what You are in our lives and what You've done. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.